Hello everyone, Kessie here today, bringing you the updated AMIB's preseason guide. And the reason it's preseason is because this guide is going out before there has been the first major update to the AMIB's in terms of balancing. So every 3 to 6 months, the ladder boards or leaderboards will be reset, and difficulty adjustments will be made every time they're reset. And so I know there's going to be a lot of them because the AMIBs right now are in like their very first stage. So everything you're seeing in this video is just to give you an idea of what to expect. But several things are still subject to change. So getting right into it, this is the red AMIB you're seeing here. It's usually considered the first one or the easiest one. There is a new section at the beginning where you're killing a bunch of like swamp dead, pirate things. They're not undead, so a silver slayer won't work. There may be some other slayer that works, but I honestly don't know what it is. I just run through these things with a Valorite weapon, and it plows through them fast enough. They're very easy monsters. This is the Firebard build, so it's a Provo Discordance Dexer using fencing. There's a lot of different builds you can take that'll work on these. Obviously, provocation is going to be a skill that's very helpful for all of these. Even though you can no longer provoke red pirates on red pirates, you can still provoke the red pirates on things like the drunken pirates or any of the other monsters inside, including undead or, you know, the krakens on the side and all that stuff. Something that may or may not change as these AMIBs go on is the availability of monsters that can be provoked on each other. Right now, most of them are set up so there's a drunken pirate or some kind of golem or something you can use to provoke the pirates onto relatively close to the other pirates, so you don't have to worry that much about not having something to provoke. But there's also some sections where it's a good idea to drag pirates or drag a certain monster over to others, so you actually do have something that works to provoke them. So we'll see how changes develop over time, but right now it's not that difficult to run into a group and there's stuff that you can always have attack each other, so you can just get going on doing damage. Skipping right ahead to the end of the Red Scroll. So something I'm hoping will change is the difficulty of the boss in the Red Scroll. He doesn't have any summons like the other scrolls, and you can provoke him onto things like the drunken pirates. So you can kill this boss without taking a single hit if you do it right, which I think is a little too easy. So hopefully that gets more difficult. As for right now, very easy. Save something that's gray named so you can provoke it, and yeah, you'll kill that boss without any difficulty. You'll notice I didn't bring a pack horse for this one. If you don't really care about getting all the items out of the chests and, you know, IDing everything, you can just bunny hop your gold out to the event center and bank it there. There's no need for a pack horse, really. It's just going to add a pet slot for you, which lowers your score. So this one, you know, pack horse is optional. Moving on to the blue. Again, I feel like a pack horse is optional in this one. There's not a whole bunch of loot on any of the monsters in the red or the blue scroll. Just small amounts of gold that you can kind of make a pile of somewhere and pick up at the end. Just going to skip through this one. There's a bunch of pirates and golems to provoke them onto towards the beginning. You just go through all that and go to a cave that's on the west wall. Inside there is the mini boss. Kill him, he has a key for the chest. Open that, you know, get the gold out and proceed onward. Oh, by the way, take telekinesis scrolls into all these if you have some magery on your character. Otherwise you're just going to be, well, very likely getting killed by the traps on the chests. And that just doesn't help your timer. You want to get through these quickly. So yeah, telekinesis scrolls are something I always bring, or if you have over 50 magery, you can just bring the regs to use the spell. Anyways, move on. This is the lighthouse. It's the final area. When you go in through the main doors, you get teleported up to the roof, oddly, and then you have to work your way down to the bottom where there is the final boss. I found the best way to approach this is to try to get him away from his minions. He summons a lot of minions. They're not up right away when you go down there, but he summons up a pile of undead. If you can get him away from those somehow, and then just plow through all the undead, provoke them, whatever you want to do, you have to kill all of them first, or you won't really be doing much damage, because it kind of mitigates over to them, which is a neat feature. But yeah, kill them all, and then there's no slayers that work for any of the bosses. That's just kind of as a balancing thing. So after you kill all the undead, unless you're using, you know, a really nice vanquishing slayer or silver, you can just use a Valorite weapon and try to plow through the final boss as quickly as you can, get the key, get the chest, and get out of there. Once again, I don't know if any of the main features of that boss are going to change once the preseason is over. It is a little difficult to separate him from his minions sometimes, because he does tend to teleport around a bit. But yeah, that's just how it is at the moment. Moving on to the next scroll. Once again, you'll see there is no pack horse with me. And you may have noticed this. I have an Effie in my pack, but I usually don't ride it just because I like the way the character graphic is hitting, you know, with a spear normally versus swinging a spear from a mount. Does it affect my time? Possibly. You know, I can go faster on a mount, but unless I'm collecting gold at the end or something, I usually don't get on my Effie for a lot of the scroll stuff. Unless I know I'm going to be fighting casters. If you're fighting casters, being on the Effie is definitely useful, so you can hit and run them a bit more effectively. Anyways, this is the purple scroll going through the beginning. It's kind of a windy beach. There's pirates at the start and undead at the end. Kind of pick and choose what you want to fight and what you want to provo. Just get through that area and you'll go up to a mini boss. It's like a sand thing. You just kill that, go down into the caves. Down there are more undead and two undead bosses. Well, two undead mini bosses that you cannot provoke. So I just take them one at a time, plow them down, and then go into the main boss area. And by the way, you do need to kill the two mini bosses to get into the main boss area, because they have keys for the gates. There's a whole system in all the AMIBs where there's keys that can actually be stolen from a lot of the bosses and mini bosses to open gates or chests or basically complete all the objectives, so you can get through in a decent time. And funny enough, you can go through all of these using a stealth character, kill pretty much nothing, but just steal all the keys and all the loot and exit. So you're not going to get the best score doing that because it's a little slow. You're just sneaking around and stealing keys and stealing loot and stuff. But it does work, so if you want to try that, you can. It's kind of like the rogue's way to get around killing all this stuff. You just sneak through the whole zone and loot everything. So that's always fun to do, if you're into it. Anyways, moving on to the main boss here. This sand snake thing is pretty cool. It summons up a bunch of skeletons, which of course you can use a silver slayer on. Again, no slayers work on the main bosses. And watch out for this guy, because you'll just be taking small amounts of damage from everything around, and they don't hit very hard. But then they'll throw that little area effect thing at you, like, two or three times in a row, and your health just is gone. So you got to keep an eye on your health bar. Try to stay well above 50% the whole time, because out of nowhere he can just burst you down with a single hit and some of that stuff, and you'll be gone. So careful when you're fighting him. Just get through that, get the chest or the key in the chest, and get out of there. Moving on to the green scroll. This one is a whole different ball of wax. And the reason I say that is because it's just so much harder than the other three scrolls. I do have a pack horse with me on this one. It's easily twice as long as all the others, and, you know, from my point of view. You start out on the pirate ship. You gotta fight your way through a bunch of pirates there. Nothing too difficult. There's drunken pirates on the ship, so you have stuff to provo. Just get through all that. You might have some trouble with some casters. My character doesn't have resist, so if anything kills me, it's usually casters anyway. Just get through all that stuff. At the end of the ship, there's like a little cave thing where the chest is. Get the key, get the chest, and then you go down into a cave, which is the main area. This has undead, and it has the main boss, which you actually fight in stages. So, skipping ahead a bit, after you've attacked the main boss for just a bit, he'll summon his first wave, which includes, well, all the waves include the same thing. It's these necromancers that cast, they hurt a lot. You will often fail provo on them a few times. Just try to get them provoked on something, kill them quickly, single them out, like one of them versus one monster. If you can provoke multiple of them onto different monsters and get damage, going that way, that's great. If not, if you're too afraid they're going to kill you, like I am, you can just take them one at a time. It does take a little longer, so it's all about risk versus reward. If you want to get a super fast time, you're going to try to do a whole bunch at once and possibly get killed by multiple casters coming after you, but you got to pick your method and just stick to it. This is a long fight. This boss will summon up two waves in this form, and then after that's done, he will move his location and go down to this kind of like, undead ritual killing area. It's got this giant blood pentagram in the middle. You can't miss it. He turns into a daemon when he does this. Doesn't make him really that much more difficult to fight, in my opinion. He still hurts. He's still a caster. I still have to use hit and run on him. So it's just a matter of getting through all the waves. There's absolutely no way to fight him while he has all of his, minions up around him. So you definitely have to do a lot of minion killing in the edges here. Just keep on pulling things apart from each other. Just lots of hit and run tactics. Lots of tactical provoking, saving some of the stronger minions to provoke against the necros, all that kind of stuff. And if you're lucky, you'll get some kind of cool drop at the end like this. But yeah, that's all four of the current AMIBs. There is a fifth one that's like a yellow golden color. I'm not sure what they're calling it yet, but it's not active in the preseason. You can still collect them when you complete all four of them on a single character. You'll get credit for it. There's like a little check system on the leaderboards. You'll see it. Once all of them are checked off, it kind of resets and then you get the scroll in your pack. And yeah, we'll see how that one goes. I'm, of course, going to be making a different video for the AMIBs when they're completed and updated and all that stuff. This one's, again, just the preseason video, so hopefully you've enjoyed watching. If you have any comments or questions, always feel free to leave them.